Our computer constantly whispers secrets out to the internet about what we do on the device. Our operating system itself is pinging centralized servers about our activities. The programs we use do the same thing. Even when we use apps that we think are offline, they're still often quietly collecting information, waiting until the moment when we reconnect to the internet to immediately share what they've collected. This continuous transmission of data from our computers to remote servers happens silently, often without our awareness or explicit consent. The privacy leak is often far more extensive than most of us realize. Fortunately, there are things that we can do to stop it from happening. There are tools that allow us to monitor all network traffic leaving our computer and block any connections that we don't want. So if you're using a calculator app, for example, and it's trying to connect with some remote server, you can just block that connection from happening. If you're on a Windows computer, you can use something called Glasswire to do this. And if you're on a Mac, you can use a program called Little Snitch. They work as a kind of outgoing firewall. Instead of trying to block data from coming into your machine, you can block outgoing data that you don't want to leave your machine. In this video, we're going to explore what kind of data is silently transmitted from your computer through things like telemetry, and then show you how to use Little Snitch to get visibility into these connections and regain control over the data leaving your computer. Our suggestions come from privacy expert Michael Bazzell, and we highly recommend that you check out his books on extreme privacy to learn more. Let's start by explaining telemetry, which makes up a bulk of the data leaving your machine. It's the automatic transmission of data sent from your devices and collected by remote servers. It usually includes how we use different programs, sending data when we perform certain actions. In Microsoft Office, for example, just starting an Office app or clicking save can send information to Microsoft. Now, telemetry and diagnostic data can be useful forensics tools. Generally, it's collected so that companies can troubleshoot and provide better services. But the problem is that a lot of the time, the user has no idea what's going on or the extent of information that's being collected. And in many apps, including Microsoft,
the telemetry and data collection cannot be turned off completely.
Sometimes it can be a real challenge to even locate telemetry settings, with options hidden and labeled with vague or even threatening language. And there are many reports of users who thought they disabled telemetry settings only to find them up and running again soon after, or to find that disabling these settings didn't stop data transmission in the first place. The MISC research team discovered that on iOS, in the X app, even when you disable sending crash reports, the app will still send them. And apparently these diagnostics are linked to you. One solution that people might try in order to avoid transmitting data across the web is to just work offline. How can an app send off information about you if there's no internet connection, right? But unfortunately, there are often processes that run silently on your computer that will just wait to send telemetry reports until the next time you reconnect to the internet. For example, when you first download Office, you also download a telemetry module called ARIA. And each time you launch your Office software, ARIA also quietly launches. ARIA is responsible for capturing activities in Office and sending this information to Microsoft each time a user closes the Office application. And if the user is not connected to the internet, ARIA stores these diagnostic events and sends them once the user has reconnected. So simply working offline is not enough to stop your computer transmitting data, but it is possible to stop your computer from connecting to certain servers, such as those known to collect telemetry. And one program you can use to do so is called Little Snitch. It's designed for Mac OS, but as mentioned, there is a similar program for Windows called Glasswire. Little Snitch allows you to see which applications are sending out data and block any outgoing data that you don't want to leave your machine. The Mac operating system itself transmits a ton of data about your activities, and all the programs you use will usually also send out data. When you have Little Snitch enabled, it will alert you every time something on your computer tries to connect to the internet, and you can decide whether you want to allow that connection or block it, and set a rule for any future connections permissions to that server. It also lets you set more fine-grained controls on your device, like how long you want a rule to last for, and the ability to limit connections to certain ports, domains, or even entire protocols. If you go to the network monitor feature, you can see all of your network activity and which domains your apps are communicating with in real time. Now, an important warning: the first time you use this program, it's going to be super annoying. You'll get like 5 alerts every second. You can't seem to do anything on your computer without first having to click a little snitch pop-up. But the sheer number of these pop-ups will make you realize just how often your computer has been communicating with the internet without you realizing. Michael Bazzell, the privacy expert I mentioned earlier, says that while Little Snitch is easily the most annoying tool for his clients, it may also provide more privacy than anything else you'll do. And once you've established your rules for certain servers, you won't get pop-ups for those connections again. So over time, the app becomes less and less noticeable. So let's try it out and look at some of the settings that you can choose. First, go to the Little Snitch website and install the app. When it opens, click Start Tour. In the menu, you have the option to put it in silent mode and automatically deny all connections, silent mode and automatically allow all connections, or alert mode. Select alert mode so that you can decide on a per alert basis which connections you want to approve or deny. Let's start with the data sent off by Apple itself. Apple does need to connect to the internet for some basic functionality, but they also collect way more data than is necessary. On the left-hand menu, you'll see a couple of rule groups that you can start with. Deselecting iCloud services will block any iCloud-related connections on your device. I personally don't use iCloud on my computer, and deselecting that option means that I never accidentally connect to iCloud services. You can also modify Little Snitch's default system settings within the Rules menu. Click the Little Snitch icon on the top of your desktop and click Little Snitch Rules to see them. Michael Bazzell explains that while you can't delete the rules which allow basic macOS and iCloud functionality, you can disable them, and he recommends unchecking these iCloud services. This will prevent iCloud and Apple services from functioning properly. But if you don't use iCloud and haven't associated an Apple ID with your machine, then you'll probably be okay with this. You'll get pop-ups asking if you want to allow specific connections, like allowing iTunes Cloud D to connect to various Apple servers. It doesn't matter whether you use iTunes, Apple Music, or iCloud, your Mac computer is constantly sending data from these apps to Apple servers, reporting information about your online activities. Take the stock Apple calendar, for example. It doesn't matter if you're not logged in to an iCloud account and have never asked your calendar to sync anything for you. Apple is still sending data about your calendar activities to their servers. To block this, open the calendar app, and on the pop-up, it will tell you that it's attempting to connect to caldav.icloud.com. You'll want to make sure that any connection is selected, forever is the duration set, and then click deny. This will make sure that your data is only stored locally on your device and not synced anywhere else or connecting to the internet. In Bazzell's settings, he blocks data being transmitted from the App Store, Find My App, Music, News, Notes, Podcasts, Stocks, Calendar, iCloud, Games, and something called ParseFBF, which is responsible for uploading Siri search analytics data. But if you use any of these apps and want internet connection, obviously make the right choices for your internet usage. He says he doesn't disable TrustD, which confirms security certificates for apps, Timed, which synchronizes time, or Software Updated, which updates the operating system, and a few others. The other option, to deselect macOS services, is more aggressive and turns off all Apple services, including stopping basically every stock application from connecting to the internet. This may break a lot of things on your computer, so tread carefully. Tweaking these settings doesn't stop 100% of Apple telemetry, but it does eliminate a lot of it. You can find Bazzell's full telemetry configuration on his Intel Techniques website if interested, and you can assess whether these settings are right for you and your computer usage. Now, let's look at some examples of apps, starting with your browser. For example, if you use Brave, open that app and you'll get a pop-up asking if Brave is allowed to send data to the internet. The browser is the main way we access the internet, so you'll want to allow that connection and select forever. Now, you'll no longer receive any prompts about Brave. Apps like your word processor that seem like they're offline are also probably connecting to different servers without you realizing. So you can block these connections too. I use LibreOffice, which is already super private, but it's worth noting that it is still connecting to servers for the purposes of automatic updates, sending crash reports, etc. You can turn all of these off inside the app itself if you don't want them, or you can block them through the Little Snitch program. But if you turn off automatic updates, it's really important that you really stay on top of updating your software yourself. Bazzell includes some specific app configurations you might want to consider. The Signal app, for example, is allowed to connect to its own servers, but everything else is blocked, which prevents URLs from being fetched when typed within a message. The Knock Knock app, which we'll go over in another video, is allowed to query virus total, but not send any telemetry back to the developers. All VLC connections are blocked. My experience with Adobe was overwhelming. There were constant connections to all kinds of servers. Because Adobe is a subscription service, some of those connections will be needed for you to use the Adobe suite, but some of them can be blocked. Basically, you can go through and block things, and if anything stops working, just undo the rule. And a reminder, to see all the rules that you've set, click the Little Snitch icon in the top of your desktop, click Little Snitch Rules, and it will show you everything you currently have set. To adjust any of them, just double click on it. One warning that we'll mention is that it can sometimes be confusing what a connection actually is and whether it's needed. Little Snitch does make it more simple by letting you know exactly which apps are sending out each connection. As you're making decisions about each app, have a think about whether that app should be connecting to the internet as part of its functionality. While Little Snitch can take a while to get your settings just right, once it's set up, your computer is going to share far less data with Apple and all of your different programs. There's a free trial of Little Snitch if you just want to try it out first, and that will last for 3 hours before shutting off. As always, Little Snitch is not a sponsor of the show. It's just a really powerful tool for privacy on your computer that at the very least really brings home just how much your computer is whispering to the broader internet as you go about the activities that you presumed were private. Most of us aren't even aware of all the data being sent off our devices. Using a reverse firewall like Little Snitch can be very revealing, turning invisible data trails into visible threads that we can cut. This way, we can make better decisions with the tech that we use and reclaim some control over our digital lives. NBTV is a non-profit that's able to create free educational content thanks to community donations. If you'd like to support the work that we do, visit nbtv.media/support. We also have a book, Beginner's Introduction to Privacy, if you're just starting out, which also supports our channel. Thanks for watching, for sharing our message, and for supporting our work. We really appreciate all of you. If you use Little Snitch or use something similar and you've learned some extra stuff that we didn't cover or know about extra connections that you think would be helpful for our audience to know about, then please let us know in the comments and maybe some of your tips will be included in a future video.